press the bell icon on the YouTube app to never miss a video from News Laundry.
This is a News Laundry podcast and you're listening to NL Interviews.
So I have with me Meghna Gulzar, the director and writer of Raazi, a film that has got rave reviews. The background noise I would like to apologize for, we're in a restaurant because she's very hungry. So we've come to eat here. Meghna, first of all, congratulations on the film. Is it overwhelming, the kind of positive reviews you've received across the board, or now they don't matter? What is your take?
No, they'll never not matter, because you're creating something to put out there for the people to opine on, and so that opinion will always be relevant and important. So yes, it is overwhelming, because the reviews have been, there's been complete approval across the board, barring one or two here or there. The numbers, the way the film is performing at the theatres, are steadily growing, so there's word of mouth, so there's an acceptance from the people. And then you come across messages which people are sending and forwarding, which says, we were watching it in this theatre, the audience stood up and clapped at the end. We were watching it here, the audience stood up and clapped. You know, that is my biggest payoff.
So how the audience reacts?
Yes, and no, and the point is, they have completely, it's not accepted, they're owning the film now. You know, it's that internalization of the film when an audience does that, where you, it is a big expression of acceptance.
Okay, I'll just tease a few things. I'll be asking Meghna about one of her shoot schedules got cancelled because of Baba Dera Sacha Sauda riots broke out.
Rahim Gurmeet Singh.
Gurmeet Singh's conviction happened the day she was supposed to shoot in Haryana. But we'll get to that later. This is a question about the politics of cinema and generally. Now, your film is a very nuanced and sensitive take at the human angle of battle. It's not a war film as in the people dying on the battlefield, but there is that human element. At any stage, and there is a certain ruthlessness to both sides, there's a certain sensitivity and vulnerability that you see on both sides. At any time you feel the pressure of having to kind of be careful, or, you know, looking over your shoulder, that if the Pakistani characters also look sympathetic, it may not be accepted because jingoism sells, because generally the kind of, you know, Indo-Pak cinema we see is very jingoistic. Was that ever a concern? I'll tell you, I mean, I'm impressed that people have understood that the Pakistanis are doing it for their country, so is she. But at any stage, did you feel that pressure? Because when you have crores riding on a film, those kind of things do matter, right?
Not during the making of it, no. Because fortunately for me, everybody involved with the film completely invested and believed in the story. And right at the script level, all these characters have been etched out and given their humanity and civility right from the script level. It just got elevated with their performances. Once the film got made and a few people started watching it, is when these external thoughts started coming. But I wasn't afraid of it. Yes, there's a chance. I mean, not only is this film not saying India is great and Pakistan is being bashed, it's not doing that. But you also have a Kashmiri Muslim as your lead protagonist, who's supposed to be a patriot. That in itself is contradictory in today's narrative.
Especially, yeah, exactly, right now what's happening.
Okay. So, and it's not something I'm unaware of, but I know that, one, I really, really have very high regard for the intelligence of my audience, both emotional and intellectual. And I know that if they connect with the character, with Sehmat and her journey, these labels are not going to matter. They will dissipate. And I think that intent and that integrity, the audience picks up very quickly from a film.
Right. So, the audience didn't boo the Pakistani, bravery and the bravado, and neither did they.
In fact, they're lauding the fact that you are showing them as human beings, and because, I mean, I'm reading comments where they're saying it's the first time a Hindi film has shown Pakistanis as humans, that we are no different. Yeah. We're actually the same.
Especially that one dialogue where he says, you know, you're doing it for your country and I'm doing it for mine, and for both of us that matters most. So, personally, you've seen Filhal was panned by critics. After that, Talwar was lauded, it also did really well. Now you've seen, you know, across the spectrum of success and failure, you've been across all of them. Would failure affect you today as much as, let's say, 10 years ago? Or does every film have the same nervousness? Do you still crave the same kind of acceptance? Or after a while, it doesn't matter as much as it did earlier?
No, so I think the failure on Talwar was, on Filhal was, it hurt emotionally because you were just starting out. And to get discouraged like that after your first film affects you a lot. And then came Just Married, which was also panned, but it hurt less.
Why?
Because I had seen the broader spectrum of it on Filhal.
Okay.
Then came Talwar, where I was blank in terms of expectations because I was just only driven by the urge to tell this story. I think everybody behind Talwar didn't expect, had no expectations from the box office, from the critics, nothing. We just wanted to tell this story. So then when that acceptance and the success came, it was overwhelming because it was unexpected and it was all new. But because I have Filhal behind me, I know I will never take success too seriously.
Right. Coming back to Raazi, during the making of the film, you had a schedule in Haryana.
Punjab.
And as your good luck would have it, Babaji's conviction happened that day and there was that riot. So tell me, what happened? What did you have to cheat? I mean, you had to cancel the shoot there. How did you change the script? Did you have to change the location? Like, how bad was it? I mean, just some little bits of excitement that happened behind, which now when you see this film, it seems also smooth. But the chaos that must have pursued when you have like a unit of 100 people landing in Haryana and Babaji's, like, people have kind of brought to a standstill. What happened? What did you do? How did you recover?
So we lost 4 shooting days. The unit was holed up in the hotels, different hotels, for 4 days because there was curfew across Punjab and Haryana and I think Delhi, parts of Delhi as well. Luckily for us, the curfew was announced at night for the following day. So we had finished the day's work, that day's work.
But you had 4 more days to go.
I had 12 days more to go in Punjab.
Mm.
I had, and then we had to go to Chandigarh and shoot for 5 days there. Our tickets to Srinagar were booked for the 15th of September. It was 170 tickets. And we knew that that can't change. So, and now I know that we lost 4 days, but at that time, sitting in Punjab, I didn't know how many days I was going to lose.
Right, you didn't know how long it would carry on.
So you can't tell when this curfew is going to end, but you knew that you had to leave for Srinagar on that day. Because the cost of rebooking everybody and cancelling those tickets would have been a very big burden to bear on a film like this. So every day it used to be, the call sheet used to get made after discussion, then there would be this 5-hour suspense of, should we publish it? We would make a few calls. Haan, lagta hai, ho jayegi shooting. Okay, publish. Another call would come. Nahin, kal bhi curfew hai. Okay, hold on, don't publish. Every evening from 5 to 9, for 5 hours this would go on, for 4 days. By which time the unit was also getting fed up. Yes, the first day we thought, okay, we got to rest because we were tired as hell. But by the third day, we were like, can we get on with it now? Because it's not like you're resting or you're being able to do any kind of recreation. You're stuck in a hotel.
So how do you make up for the loss? Do you change the script? Do you cut out a scene?
No, we gave up all our break days. And we shot non-stop for 22 days. Our last sequence was a night shoot, which should have had pre-lighting. But the lightmen went from lighting in the day to shooting at night and were fatigued to the extent that they were not being able to carry the boosters at night. We couldn't complete the sequence because we got no pre-light. So we're covering like a 3-kilometer area in Patiala, near Neemrana and the gardens over there. So as we're shooting, as we are moving, the lights are moving with us. The generator is moving with us.
So
we're lighting
time
up.
To actually light up and then arrive at set.
So we didn't finish our shoot. Dawn broke and our sequence wasn't completed. And I think that's the first time that happened on this film, that we had never completed a call sheet. So that, I think, also downed the morale of the unit. And we left, we didn't even have a rest day. We went to the hotel, showered, changed and left for Chandigarh. And we had to shoot the next day.
So have you seen MSG, by the way?
No. Should I?
I don't know. So as filmmaker,
have you seen it?
No, I haven't had the guts. But I thought you're a filmmaker, so you might want to see what your contemporaries are doing before they went to jail.
No, unfortunately, I missed that one. I believe there's a second part as well.
I think he made three finally. Mm-hmm. Okay. Mm. So now Kashmir is in such severe conflict. I don't think anyone in their right mind can go shoot there. Mm. As in the very.
Actually, there are a lot of films being shot there.
As we speak.
This is what I'm saying. While I was there, there were two units wrecking and two units shooting.
No, I'm talking about today. Things are really terrible today.
So the thing is, these things are cyclical. There'll be like one episode that will happen, then there'll be like unrest for some time, then things calm down. So like when I was shooting there, there were two units shooting and two units wrecking, apart from me.
So what was it like shooting in Kashmir? I mean, do you have a take on Kashmir? I mean, do you have, what is your politics on it? Do you have a view on it from your experience of shooting there? What was your experience like?
Ours was very smooth. The people are very warm and lovely. For me, it was beautiful because I've gone there as a child while my parents were shooting. And now I've gone to shoot there myself. It's still as beautiful. The people are still as warm. Yes, there is unrest, but I feel that, and you know, the thing is that there is militancy, there are people, there is a section of the Kashmiri population which is militant and perhaps anti-India, but it's not the entire people of Kashmir. And to stroke them all with the same broad brush is unfair. Because you do have pockets, other pockets of people like this all over our country.
Yeah, in some form or the other. Okay, last two questions. One here is, you're not, I noticed, very active on social media. But each time a Bollywood celebrity expresses or articulates a viewpoint, a political viewpoint, there is a backlash one way or the other. And there is this entire political viewpoint from Bollywood of Hindi film industry or even the South is kind of can damage your your market, because you know if you're non-controversial then you have fans across political ideologies. What is your take on that? You personally, do you hold your tongue on issues like this? How do you look at this new environment where market valuations could be impacted by your politics?
I honestly, I don't subscribe to living like that, because then you can't say a word. Because you don't know which market you're going to be damaging and offending who. Mm. Everybody stands up. Everybody is very entitled on social media. You are entitled to react, but the person who's giving the opinion is not entitled to the opinion. Why?
Right.
Me personally, for me, social media is, I mean, when I really, really get affected by something or when I have a film to talk about is when I do it. But just to make my presence felt, I will not go and comment on everything that's happening. I think the backlash also comes from that. When you sense a hollowness behind those statements is when the backlash comes. But when people are, you know, earnestly saying what they have to, this is what I'm saying, that, you know, we need to give the intelligence of our people a little more respect. You know, not all of the backlash is hollow. Some of it is deserved, some of it is not. But all I'm saying is that social media is becoming a place of entitlement. And it's becoming a place of bullies. Which is not the best way to use it. I'm sure it was intended and designed for better things.
So the last question, Meghna, do you want to weigh in on this entire debate that was sparked off with Karan Johar about nepotism in the film industry, and it carried on for a lot of time, and I know it must have been quite difficult to be always compared to your father Gulzar, but when this entire thing broke, everybody weighed in with all sorts of views and then retracted. Many of them retracted their views also. Do you have like a set view on this? You want to weigh in?
My set view is my life experience. Mm. My last name is Gulzar. My first film was a flop. It took me 7 years to make my next film. So much for nepotism.
Okay, good luck with your film and congratulations on its success. Mm. And please enjoy your very tasty looking sandwich.
Thank you.
All News Laundry podcasts are available on iTunes and Stitcher and any other podcast platform.